In this video, we'll look at the workflows of color matching and selective color correction. When it comes to color correction, we never just work on a single shot. Normally, a shot forms part of an edit in the sequence, and everything needs to match appropriately. So let's start off with this shot. This gladiator is looking quite blue. This could have been shot on a different day with a different light and another camera. Regardless of this, you need to balance the colors with the other segments in the sequence. To balance this shot, you need to see the other points in the sequence at the same time. Click on the View Mode pull-down menu and change to the Triptych Player. You will now get three positioners in the sequence with three views. You have the option to force the positioners to look at the previous, current, and next shots. But you can also set the positioners to free, which means you can scroll to any shot in the sequence. So scroll the Triptych Right positioner further down the sequence to find a good reference. Using this shot as the reference, we will select the blue gladiator and add the color warper timeline effects. Going into the editor, you are still able to see the Triptych player. So it will be easy to color correct your shot by matching the colors from the reference. The time bar currently only shows the duration of the current segment. If you want to see the entire sequence in the time bar, click the Options pull-down menu. Change the display range from segment to timeline. This means that you can select the right viewer and adjust the reference directly in the editor. The viewers are independent of each other, so remember to select the viewer before adjusting their respective positioner in the time bar. To balance this shot, you could color correct it manually, or you could use the automated color matching. To match one shot to the other, click the Select button. A message will prompt you to select an area to be modified. With the cursor, click and drag a box on the gladiator's top. When you release the cursor, a blue LED appears on the Select button, telling you it has made a selection. Press the Select button again, and the message will prompt you to select the area to match to. On the reference shot, drag the cursor over the gladiator's shirt. As soon as you release the cursor, the color warper does a match. It's pretty much balanced, but you can still tweak the shot further if you choose. I'll exit the editor and switch back to the standard viewer. The final workflow example is selective color correction. I'll go to the shot in the sequence where we have some legs running towards the camera. Let's say, for instance, that you've been asked to change the color pads on the trousers. Select the segments and, using the effects ribbon, add a color warper timeline effects. Now go straight into the editor. The color warper has up to three selectives, known as secondaries, to isolate color. The first thing is to switch the color warper's mode to work on selective 1. The image goes monochrome. This specific view is only for selectives. This is called the selective view, and it is for picking the color. Enable Selective 1 and press Pick Custom. With the picker, you can click and drag on the padding to select the color. To fine-tune the key, you can switch the view from Selective View to the Matte View. The color warper affects the black areas of the matte. Any gray areas represent falloff, and the white areas remain unaffected. In essence, the diamond keyer in the color warper is used for color isolation. Notice the two diamond shapes in the color cube. The inner diamond is the tolerance, and the outer diamond is the softness. Whatever color value falls within the diamonds are affected, and whatever is outside the diamond shapes remains unaffected. You can interactively adjust the key by moving the points on the diamond shapes. You can also adjust the luminance scale to isolate these colors in different levels of brightness. To assist you with fine-tuning the matte, you can click on the Plot button and sample a point on your image. A black dot appears in the diamond keyer, and you can tweak the shapes around the point. You can also blur the matte to help create color bleed that is common when blending color correction. Hold Control Option and dragging the sliders will adjust the blur proportionately. Now to color correct the pads, you need to change to the result view. So you are still working on selective 1, but seeing the overall grade generated by the color warper. As an example, you can adjust the hue slider to change the color of the pads. If you want to keep grading the overall image on top of the selectives, just switch back to working on the master. Press exit and you can scrub or play a preview of the effect. Press render to process the final result. As a workflow tip, timeline effects, including color corrections, can be saved as a preset. Drag the effect off the effects pipeline and drop it into the library. You can drag this onto any segment in the sequence. Please move on to the next video to continue your smoke getting started experience.